Good evening and welcome. You're watching the News Hour Agenda. I'm Padmaja Joshi. We were the first ones, day before yesterday, to get you images of the violence in Bengaluru as it was unfolding. Then we told you how this was planned and executed as part of a well-thought-out conspiracy. But there have been apologists over the last 48 hours, apologists for this murderous mob who sought to rationalize the violence as a spontaneous reaction to a social media post. There were people who said that this was only a cry for justice. People who felt slighted wanted the police to act. And it is for these apologists that now I'm going to put in front of you evidence. Evidence on camera, evidence in black and white. Evidence to show that this was not an angry outburst of people who were only demanding the arrest of the man they deemed guilty of insulting the prophet. Their aim was much more sinister and chilling. I want to start by showing you a series of messages that were exchanged on social media platforms on Tuesday evening. Exchanged as people were being provoked, incited, driven into a frenzy. Message number one. Gustakh Nabi ki ek saza, sartan se juda, sartan se juda. Another person then goes on to say that any sort of a mistake means death. Now I want you to take a look at message number two. Is zamane mein gazi hona zaruri hai. Jhagde kya? Gardan uda deni chahiye. Message number three. Enough of being slighted by the non-believers. MLA hai to kuch bhi karega. Ghar mein ghus ke marenge. We will enter his house and we will take revenge. Message number four. It goes on straight away to say, this MLA will die the kind of death that has never been seen before. Yes, you can pretend and turn your face away, but this is the harsh truth. And the purpose of putting out this evidence is very simple. To finally call out the people who are trying to cover up for this mob. To try and rationalize their violence as some appeal for justice. Let's make no mistake, this was a mob that wanted to kill. If you want to remain in denial after these messages, well, perhaps you'll say that these messages are written in a fit of anger. Then let me show you what followed. This same mob that was exchanging messages on social media then descended on the KG Halli police station and wreaked havoc, destroying everything in their path. Slogans were raised outside of vengeance, of instant justice. So, will people still now be in denial now that all of this is evidence on camera? Will the mob mania in Bengaluru still be explained away as some benign demand for justice? Or will political opportunism get you to turn a blind eye to this naked call of violence and let this rot fester?
The News Hour at 10, debate number one on Times Now, Super Prime Time.
Joining us now on the debate, we have Tejasvi Surya, Member of Parliament of the BJP from Karnataka South, Ziad Nomani, eyewitness to this violence, Rafiq Ahmed Sheikh, former MLA and leader of the Congress, Dr. Tasleem Ahmed Rehmani, National Secretary of the SDPI, by the way, main accused in this entire violence case, Islamic scholar Shoaib Jamai and senior journalist Ashutosh Mishra. I want to start by asking you, Dr. Rehmani, naturally, after these videos, I want to quote to you from the FIR that has been registered in the KG Halli arson case. People came together, I'm quoting from the FIR. People came together, shouted slogans that the police should be attacked to death. The mob said Naveen should be handed over to them so they could kill him. They used lethal weapons, machetes, knives, rods, sticks, and stones. The police asked the people to disperse. They said, "We will go only when we accomplish what we have come for." They tried to pull weapons from the police. Now, I have seen you say that this was only a mob that was angry because they were denied justice. Is this how you seek justice, sir? Ask for people to be beheaded?
No. Not at all. And I'm sure these messengers, whosoever posted such messages, must have been identified and arrested by now, and if not, must be arrested right now. And I appeal, and I with a lot of my conviction, I say they must be arrested at the first hand. There is no place of such messages, and we cannot address, and no civil society can bear such
kind of messages. It is not whosoever. It is not whosoever, sir. It is, I will tell you who these people are. They are members of the SDPI, and I will name them for you. District Secretary Muzammil Pasha, Firoz, Afraz, other members of the SDPI.
No.
They are all belonging to your organization.
Are you trying to
suggest that it's not as if some strangers descended from the heavens and started setting things on fire?
Are you trying to suggest that this message has been put by Muzammil Pasha or SD? How do you know that?
How do you know that? Because the police has booked them.
From SDPI?
He was the one who motivated people. He is the one who has been arrested.
Registered an FIR and booked the people for not such messages. Police did not say that these messages belong to these people.
Okay, so what have they arrested him for? For peaceful protest. He was sitting there on a fast unto death.
You cannot be sure that these
Muzammil Pasha was doing satyagraha.
Posted by Muzammil Pasha or SDPI people.
Right.
How can you say that?
So why do you think these four men have been arrested?
Police FIR will go to the scrutiny, to the inquiry committee and to the court.
Okay.
Whatever the police has written in the FIR is not a final
word. Tejasvi Surya, SDPI people have been arrested.
But that is not because they exchanged these messages.
These are some unknown, faceless, nameless people. They are not nameless. Their names are quite apparent of what they had been writing. 6 p.m. is when the FIR was registered. By 7 p.m., the mobilization had begun. For everyone, people like Mr. Rehmani, who are sitting there and saying that people were very upset because no action was being taken, by 7 p.m. it was very clear what was the intention, what was the plan. But it's unfair to name the SDPI, Tejasvi Surya.
Good evening, Padmada. Thank you. I just want to broaden the scope of this debate. The screenshots that you have been displaying on your television screen uses the words like infidel, uses the word kafir, uses the word unbeliever. Says that if anybody insults the God, then they must be punished with death. Where are these lines coming from? Where is this vocabulary coming from? This is something that as a civil society which values pluralism, which values liberalism, we must be asking these questions, Padmaja. Because these are not something that is new. We have been seeing the same kind of language is used not only in Bangalore this time, but was also used in Charlie Hebdo in France. It was used earlier in Bangalore when a cartoon was made and there was a riot because of that.
Do you want to endorse the Charlie Hebdo or this Naveen? Yeah, I have an objection to what you are saying. You are trying to provoke the sentiments.
Mr. Rehmani, just a second. Nobody is endorsing what he said. But you can't for a moment suggest that somebody can be beheaded or somebody can write on WhatsApp saying MLA ko aisi maut marenge jaisa kabhi dekha na gaya ho. Are you suggesting that because your feelings are hurt, somebody is going to be murdered?
Tell me then,
Can you please give me 30 seconds
Are you standing with Naveen?
Sir, nobody is standing with Naveen. The man is in jail. If anyone was standing by Naveen, he would not be in jail. What is this? What is this facetious argument that you are making? Please do not miss the woods for the trees. Please do not miss the woods for the trees to say that giving a call to murder is standing with Naveen, standing with somebody insulting or engaging in blasphemy is an absolutely ridiculous and fallacious argument. Just a second. Before you make this point, let Tejasvi Surya complete. Yes, go on. Finish your point, Tejasvi Surya.
Can you please ask him to be silent for 30 seconds and hear me out? Yes.
No, if you will, if you will try to endorse Charlie Hebdo and Naveen, then I will have no other option.
Mr. Rahmani, why are you heckling condoning something that nobody is condoning? You are making a charge that nobody is even doing.
You are talking about supporting a man who's already in jail.
Why are you trying to derail the argument? I'm going to have to mute you for 30 seconds. Please finish your point, Tejasvi Surya. I want to bring in the others then. Yes, go on.
Yes, thank you. Nobody here is condoning what was written by Naveen. What we are saying is, if there is a post or a statement which is made by any person against the religious sentiments of anybody, then there is a way of addressing it in the constitutional system. You can file an FIR, you can go to the police, you can file a private complaint before a magistrate. There is a certain procedure that is undertaken. None of that is given, none of that is followed here. In Hindus, when M.F. Hussein characterized and pictured our gods and goddesses in a nude fashion, did they burn police stations? Did they attack 60 policemen in uniform? Did they do any of this? I am going on record and condemning what Naveen did. Nobody is supporting Naveen. But does that mean because Naveen did a mistake and posted a Facebook post, does that give an unbridled right to these hooligans to go and burn a police station? Does it give them an unbridled right
answer,
to
Mr. Rahmani,
policemen in uniform?
Now that you've got unequivocal condemnation for what Naveen did, you tell me, does it give the right to people to ask for somebody's death?
They are already arrested. Now let the law take its course. They are arrested already. If they are culprit, they will be punished.
So if they are culprit,
why you are propagating it out of proportion?
Sir, I am showing you evidence. Is there still any doubt about how this was a criminal intent? This was a plot to kill.
They will be punished.
What are you talking about if they are a culprit? I want to ask you, before that I wanted to watch a video before you come in, Shoaib Janai, of a writer who's standing outside the police station engaging in sloganeering. This video number one where he says the MLA must come here. The commissioner must come here. We want instant justice. You watch this video and then you tell me if this is innocent, enraged, hurt people asking for justice. Or is this an implicit call to violence?
What shall be done to these people?
Sir, why are you shouting? I'm just playing out evidence for you. I'm playing out evidence.
No, I'm not
shouting. Watch this. Shoaib Janai, watch this.
I'm asking you the suggestion.
Sir, ask me after I...
No! उसी अरेस्ट कर को ले ले काको दिखाना नहीं हटेंगे मारे तो मारेंगे कहते भी होंगे
अगर हमें यहाँ से हटेंगे नहीं
What is this, Shoaib Jamai? Telling people, get the commissioner here, get the MLA here, writing messages which say, Gustakh Nabi ki ek saza, sar tan se juda, sar tan se juda. Can you believe that we are living in a democracy?
What is wrong?
And this is the IT capital of our country. It's shameful.
Is it a crime to change Narayan Takbir?
No, it is not. But it is definitely a crime to say that somebody who is going to insult the prophet is going to be beheaded. That definitely is a crime.
Padmaja, am I allowed to say?
Yes, go on.
That is a crime. But raising the Narae Takbir and Narae Risalat is not a crime. Don't try to paint it that as if
nobody is painting anything. Nobody is painting anything, sir. Please don't try and play the victim card over here. Please don't play the victim card. I am very clear about the questions I am asking over here. And I'm showing you evidence. So please don't sit here and play victim as if you are being painted into a corner. Don't for a moment pretend to do that.
Of this chanting.
Tejasvi Surya.
We proud raising Narae Takbir and Narae Risalat. There is no victim card. I declare it that I proud to raise a Narae Takbir whenever I want to praise my Allah. And Narae Risalat whenever I want to praise my Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I'm not ashamed of it. And don't try to take me ashamed at the name of this slogan.
Mr. Rahmani, I have just one question for you. Do you believe that the person who has
I don't see anything wrong in that.
Must be beheaded. Do you believe in this? Do you believe that he must be beheaded? Or do you think he must be tried under Section 295 of ICC?
Those people must be arrested anybody. The people who are raising these kind of sentences and slogans that to behead anybody, those people must be arrested and punished, severely punished.
Okay, great. So you're happy that members of your organization have been arrested for what they did? I'm glad you at least concede that these people belong in jail and the strictest punishment for attempt to murder should be given to them.
If really they did it, they must be punished. That must be investigated thoroughly by a court of law, and if they are found guilty, they must
be punished. Okay, great. And you accept that this was an attempt to try and kill somebody, going by the evidence that has been put out.
Maybe some people, but that is not. Maybe that doesn't some mean people. That it was SDPI
All right,
or
great.
PFI.
I'm happy that you're at least conceding because since yesterday we have been told one that these people were angry because the police did not arrest Naveen. Second, that this is the failing of the police because it was a law and order situation. Third, that this was not an attempted murder. This was not a pre-planned conspiracy.
It was a result of a family feud.
These are the excuses that have been thrown at us. I am at least glad that you have conceded this was a conspiracy to murder.
This is not
yes,
an
go
excuse.
On.
This
Shoaib
is the reality
now make your
that
point.
The police failed to perform its duty on time.
Shoaib Jamai.
Sir, Padmaja, this is my turn. Please allow me to speak. Three points I would like to put up here. The first thing is that, yes, my sentiments had been hurt. I was deeply hurt, but I should not resort to any kind of violence. And I don't believe that violence is the solution. And the second point is that what you saw in the video, it was nothing wrong. People are saying, we want justice. Everyone wants justice. People are saying, Allah Akbar. As in Ayodhya, you see people are chanting, Jai Shri Ram. People are saying, call the commissioner. People are saying, arrest them in front of them. There is nothing wrong in
sir,
that.
Sir, why are you selectively, picking up from what I have said? Do you see anything wrong with somebody saying, great job, mar hi dalna tha usko? Do you see anything wrong with that? I am actually showing you screenshots which have now been taken by the police.
Yes.
Is there or isn't there anything wrong?
मैं आपको बताता हूँ ये सारे ट्रोलर्स हैं सोशल मीडिया में फेसबुक पे या यूट्यूब पे आप देखेंगे
really?
मैं तो समझता हूँ कि तेजस्वी सूर्या जो बैठे हैं वो सबसे बड़े ट्रोलर्स हैं कुछ साल पहले उन्होंने अरब के महिलाओं का अपमान करते हुए एक बड़ा गलत ट्वीट
Sir,
किया था
why are you अगेन डीरेलिंग द कॉन्वर्सेशन बाय मेकिंग अ पर्सनल अटैक आई एम शोइंग यू एविडेंस ऑफ पीपल हु आर आस्किंग फॉर वायलेंस
कानून को हाथ में लेने का अधिकार नहीं है आंसर
देश में सारे लोग
आर यू इन फेवर ऑफ फीमेल जेनिटल म्यूटिलेशन
खेलने की कोशिश किसी को नहीं करनी चाहिए वन शुड नॉट प्ले
सर आई एम टेलिंग यू अबाउट मैसेजेस व्हिच आर आस्किंग फॉर मर्डर and you are comparing it to something else why just fight they should be beheaded jhagda kyu karna unka sar kalam kar do this you think is casual trolling i haven't seen a worse normalization of a call to murder
i also receive such kind of messages every day
then in that case sir you should definitely go and lodge a complaint with the police because i think it's a very very serious offense if somebody is threatening to behead you i wish you well and i hope that person rots in jail please don't sit here on tv and say this is हार्मलेस ट्रोलिंग सर मैंने भी बहुत ट्रोलर देखे मैंने किसी को ये नहीं देखा है कहते हुए कि उसको झगड़ा क्यों करना जाके सर कलम कर दो एमएलए को ऐसी मौत दो जैसे कभी देखा ना हो यू कैन सिट ऑन नेशनल टेलीविजन एंड से अरे दीज आर ट्रोल्स नॉट नथिंग बिग यू नो वी विल जस्ट सेट अ पुलिस स्टेशन ऑन फायर
यू केम टू शाइनबाग आंदोलन आई हैव डन न्यूमरस शोस विद यू इन शाइनबाग एंड आई वाज प्रेजेंट देयर
सर कहाँ आप शाहीन बाग को ला रहे हो बीच में शाहीन बाग पे हम अलग डिस्कशन करेंगे यहाँ पर लोग गए और उन्होंने जा करके आग लगा दी द एमएलएस हाउस वॉज बर्न टू द ग्राउंड हिज ब्रदर्स हाउस वॉज अटैक डू यू नो एंड वी जस्ट गेटिंग इन न्यूज व्हेन यू टॉक अबाउट हार्मलेस ट्रोलिंग व्हेन यू टॉक अबाउट हार्मलेस ट्रोलिंग आशुतोष मिश्रा अ मैन In Uttar Pradesh has put a bounty of 51 lakh rupees on the head of Congress MLA's nephew. There is a man sitting in Uttar Pradesh's Meerut who has the gall to say on camera, if you get me the head of Naveen, I'm going to get you 51 lakh rupees. It is shocking and appalling that people like Shoaib Jamai normalize these calls to violence, which emboldens people like this. Listen to this man. Listen to this man of Meerut and perhaps you will think he's a harmless troll who's saying get me somebody's head I will give you 51 lakh rupees
taki ki hai main uski kade shabdon mein ninda karta hu aur us yuvak ko jo huzur ki shaan mein gustakhi ki hai us yuvak ka jo sar kalam karke layega use main 51 lakh rupaye ka nagad inaam dunga aur mere samaj ke log muslim samaj ke log उस पैसे को इकट्ठा करने में मेरे साथ मदद करेंगे
What is this, Ashutosh Mishra? Is this a harmless troll?
It's not, and this man should be arrested. The thing is that when I listen to
Surya equating this with global Islamic terrorism,
and you saying that this was all pre-planned, it's a cause of great concern that our intelligence agencies keep failing time and again. This time it's Karnataka. Earlier it was in Pulwama, where our CRPF soldiers were martyred. So if there is so much, and why does it always happen?
You know, it's funny because these same intelligence agencies, when they picked up, when they picked up people for the Bhima Koregaon violence, it was said that activists are under attack in our country, that freedom of expression is being snuffed out by a fascist government. If the violence would have happened, sir, then you would have said intelligence failure has happened. When people were picked up, you said, oh, journalists and activists are silenced in Modi's fascist India. You can't have it one way and the other, Ashutosh Mishra.
You can have another debate on Shaheen Bagh. So let's stick to today's debate. Don't go to Bhima Koregaon. Don't try to divert it. Just like you are asking.
No. Jamai not to go I am to asking Bagh. You specifically. So if you are saying that intelligence, that police should act on intelligence, then you agree that Surendra Gadling arresting him was a preemptive strike by the police?
My cause of concern as a citizen.
That is Sudha Bharadwaj is in bail or in jail. It was a preemptive strike by the police.
Time and again, and it's always in a BJP ruled state that we see that. The citizens try to attack police. If you remember, a SHO was killed in UP in Bulandshahr. A police party was attacked in Kanpur, and
okay.
So eight people were killed.
Okay, you come from so the city. You come from the city, Tejasvi Surya. Why didn't you know that something like this is happening? You should have arrested these people preemptively.
And the intelligence agencies always come up proper.
Tejasvi Surya.
Padmaja. The moment an FIR was filed, the moment this was reported to the police station, the FIR was filed against the person who made the post.
immediately you have just been telling that this is lie, and Padmaja has been telling that this is pre-planned. Where was the administration and where were the intelligence agencies? Why are you now trying
to guarantee me, sir, that the police are not under the control of the government?
Please accept that. Please accept that. Because if you don't accept that you have failed, these things will keep on repeating. And these violent elements will bring bad name to the country. You keep talking about secularism and this and that. Why don't you talk about law and order, which is much more important? Why don't you raise this issue?
Please, Ashutosh Mishra, shame on you and your compatriots. Your behavior has always been shameful. You have done nothing for the country except bringing bad name. What are you trying to do? Why, Ganeshan?
Instead of accepting the failure of the police, you are trying to use it for your divert attention from BJP's failure.
Oh, really? So this has, you know, this is funny actually, because this is what Congress's Nasser Hussain yesterday also said, that this violence was orchestrated to divert attention from the BJP's failure in tackling COVID. I mean, of the ridiculous excuses that are being made for a mob, this has to be a new one. But I want to ask you, Ziad Nomani, you've got Mr. Rehmani saying that this was just a disparate mob. There was no political backing. There was no involvement of the SDPI. What did you see, Ziad Nomani?
See, I've been waiting to speak on this, and let me be very clear and very frank on this. This is wrong. Those were not random mobs. Those mobs belonged to certain organization. They were actually mobilized. How were they mobilized? On what basis were they mobilized? What were the channels what mobilization were used? The police is investigating, and I'm very sure that will come into light. But again, I would like to congratulate Tejasvi Surya, because Tejasvi Surya, I'm very sure you're the happiest person or your party is happy. Because when such riots happen, when people are killed, when there's division between society, that is when your party comes into power and that is when you gain strength to come up. And I'm not saying this. This is coming from a well-read report. So I'm congratulating you.
Are you suggesting that Naveen, you both are responsible.
Whether the religion does not...
I'm not suggesting anything, madam. I'm saying the ideology that he comes from, Tejasvi Surya, and he was using, he was asking where is his words coming from, pro-KP words. Let me tell you, those pro-KP words are coming from where it came from in Delhi riots, from where it came from in UP. There's a chief minister in UP who's sitting on a stage, and there is a party leader who's saying, hum minorities ko maar kar unki bachiyon ko kabar se rape karenge. These are the words you're talking
about. You are the eyewitness of yesterday's violence. Instead of making a political point, you know, I have to say this, just a second, Ziad Nomani, you being an eyewitness say there was mobilization, this was pre-planned, but yet you do not name the party that did the mobilization. Instead, you say the BJP is going to benefit. Tell me in yes or no, are you saying the BJP did the mobilization? If yes, name the BJP, and if not, name who is behind the mobilization. Name who is behind the mobilization.
I have already named SDPI and PFI continuously. I have done that. If you are, if I am loud and clear, I am naming them.
Great.
But at the same time, please understand that we can't be selective. We can't be selective. What SDPI, PFI, if they have been involved, investigation is going on. That will come. They are involved. Someone has mobilized it. It will come into picture. But again, when I come to Tejasvi Surya, those words you're talking about are coming from your party, from your men. Those were the words in Delhi riots. Those were being used. Why don't you play those figures? Why don't you play those video clips? Are you forgetting it? You're talking about ek MLA ko marne ki baat kari. I will tell you from where it's coming. Ek MP tha Ehsan Jafri Gujarat riots mein CM ko call kiya bachne ke liye. Tab bhi nahi bachaya gaya. Us time agar insaaf diya gaya hota, to is tarah ke jo mauka parast log hain, nafrat ki rajneeti wale jo wahan par danga kar kar hai DJ Ali mein aur Academy Srinivas Murthy ka jo MLA ka ghar jala kar aaye, but agar Ehsan Jafri ko roka gaya to insaaf dilaya gaya hota, to baat yahan tak.
Ziad Nomani, answer the question. Ziad Nomani, answer the question. You are saying you are analyzing this flare up and you say that the BJP stands to gain from it. The fact of the matter is, criminal prosecution will happen of people who have committed the crime. What the political fallout is not a criminal act. The crime is the one that gets prosecuted. Answer the question that Tejasvi Surya is asking.
They have to be prosecuted, but don't just look at this crime. Let's talk about the larger picture. Let's talk about the country. Let's talk about politics and empathy.
Listen to the question. Mr. Nomani, listen to the question.
What I'm saying is,
why is it that this behavior of this particular community happens this way throughout the world? And it has been happening from the last 1,400
years. No, I don't agree with that argument. I'm sorry. I don't agree with that argument at all. You cannot make this about a community. Yes, there are criminal elements. Yes, there is a party which for political benefit is going to whip up communal passions. But let's not make this about communities. Please.
I don't agree with you on this.
Well, you can disagree with me on this, but this is my platform and I totally refuse to endorse that statement. But yes, the SDPI, which for communal gains, which for political gains, is using the communal card. And now I want to bring in the Congress as well, because we've got Rafiq Ahmed Sheikh here with us. Rafiq Ahmed Sheikh, you know what is the bigger shocker? The biggest shocker for me was that despite the fact that Mr. Akhand Murthy is a senior MLA of your party, despite the fact that two more leaders, Rizwan Arshad and Zameer Ahmed, were beaten up by this mob, despite the fact that this mob circulated messages saying that iska sar kalam kar do, you had Zameer Ahmed Khan going for the last rites of one of the writers.
The man who was beaten by the mob goes for the last rites of a writer today. What is the message you're sending out?
Mr. Rahmani, can you please give some chance to Mr. Sheikh to speak? Go on, Mr. Sheikh. What is your compulsion?
I'm just correcting you. You must have to quote those boys who are standing outside the Hanuman temple for its protection. You will not quote that, because you also want to communalize it, communally polarize the situation in the Bangalore city, which is going to poll just after 2 months, and BJP has to get power over there. We are not in the frame, Bangalore.
Who can be heard on the camera? Jaldi se jaldi upload karo. Is it a PR stunt? Who are they trying to protect the temple? We have seen the history of your community protecting temples in India. We have seen it.
Yes, has happened.
We don't need our community to be protecting temples in India.
Hanuman temple,
okay,
by making a human shrine. There are good
You may not need anything civilized in the country. You only want a war all over. You want
Mr. Sheikh, please do not try and avoid the question I asked you. Don't try and get into another debate. My question to you is very straightforward. Can I please reduce the audio of Mr. Rahmani, because he's not letting me ask a specific question, to Mr. Rafiq Ahmed Sheikh, former MLA of the Congress. Mr. Sheikh, give me one reason why you had a sitting MLA of the Congress go for the last rites of a writer who was killed in the process of trying to burn down a police station. Give me one reason.
See, the Deputy Commissioner of Police has requested our ex-minister and sitting MLA, Zameer Ahmed Khan, and Arshad Rizwan, the sitting MLA, to go to the constituency and convince the people not to involved in such activities. They went there immediately. But by that time, see, there are so many reasons. Let investigation go on.
We'll come to know. Investigation will go on. My question to you is specific. Three people were killed in police firing after they engaged in riots, arson, stone pelting, violence, attempt to murder. One of those rioters, his last rites were attended by a Congress MLA. He went for the last rites of a rioter. Tell me why. Why?
No, Zameer Ahmed is a social worker, not only a political leader, he is a social worker. He goes even to the COVID patient who died. He went to the funeral, he attended, he took care of the funeral.
Oh, that's sweet.
Similarly, he has gone there.
So you go for the last rites of all rioters.
You see, he has gone to the incident place to request the people.
He went for the last rites of a man killed in police firing, because he was rioting. He did not go for a COVID patient's last rites. He did not go for somebody who was an unclaimed body. He went for a rioter's final rites. I want to ask you, what is the compulsion?
See, the rioter's mother says he went for some work. He went out of the, I mean, to after finishing his job, By the time the firing took place and he died. Let the, that's what I'm telling. Let the investigation complete.
Well, the Congress is a very altruistic party than Tejaswi Surya is all one can say. They are, you know, they're like, oh, he happened to be a writer, but it's sad that he is dead. So we must go for his last rites because, you know, human, being human. Possibly.
Padmaja, the Congress is beyond exposed here. The Congress and the SDPI are two sides of the same coin. The SDPI at least has the conviction and gumption to say out and out that we are a Muslim-only party. The Congress, on the other hand, can neither say that they are in support of the Islamic element, can they be in support of the Dalit MLA. This clearly exposes the pusillanimous lack of conviction of the Congress party. They are the party of nobody. And it is extremely sad.
Congress party is a secular party. It is for the all communities.
This house has been burned down. Neither the Congress party president nor Rahul Gandhi have even tweeted a condemnation in support of the Congress MLA. It just shows
everyone.
Congress party
not only with one committee or one person. It's with all people and all secular. It's a secular party.
Which is extremely unfortunate.
Very sweet. You know, Mr. Sheikh, I'm very happy that at least in the end you also made it very clear that the Congress stands with everyone. Even if they happen to be people who are calling for murder, even if they happen to be people who are engaging in rioting, if that is your idea of secularism, then God help you and God help this country. If you continue to be in denial about a danger and you're going to let the rot fester, then sooner or later, you're not only going to be called out, you're also going to be voted out. Please don't let that happen because the country suffers when you do that. Thank you very much, all gentlemen, for having joined me on the News Hour Debate.